Tuesday, beloveds. Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday. God has an exciting, exciting prophetic word for us. But let us begin with a word of prayer. Father, just cover this word with the blood of Jesus. Minister to the hearts of your people, Lord. Let them not hear me, but let them hear you through me. Let this be a word of confirmation, a word of release, a word that will launch somebody into the next season of their lives. I cover this word with the precious blood of Jesus. Thank you even for the testimonies that are coming from this word. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, beloveds. As per usual, we are starting with the greetings. Greetings in Germany. Welcome, Germany, to Healing Springs of Life Prophetic International Ministries. When I saw you on our geography log, I said, wow, yet another country has joined the family. So welcome, Germany, to Healing Springs of Life Prophetic International Ministries. Greetings in Istanbul, Turkey. Greetings in Singapore. Greetings in Guyana. Greetings in Indonesia. Greetings in Sri Lanka. Greetings in China. Greetings in America. And in America, greetings in Colorado Springs. Greetings in Buffalo, New York. Greetings in Iowa. Greetings in Las Vegas, Nevada. Greetings in Siegelville, Texas. Greetings in Augusta, Georgia. Greetings in Madison, Illinois. Greetings in Irvine, California. Greetings in Indiana. Greetings in Florida. Greetings in Los Angeles, California. Greetings in Alabama. Greetings in Mississippi. Greetings in Charlotte, North Carolina. Greetings in Chicago, Illinois. Greetings in Brooklyn, New York. Greetings in Portland, Oregon. Greetings in India. Greetings in Mumbai, India. Greetings in Kerala, India. Greetings in South Africa. Greetings in Durban. Oh my goodness, when I saw you commenting in the comment section that you're from Durban, I got so excited. Welcome, Durban, South Africa, to Healing Springs of Life Prophetic International Ministries. Greetings in Mpumalanga. Greetings in the Free State. Greetings in Welkom. Greetings in Senegal. Greetings in Heilbron. Greetings in Kroonstad. Greetings in Pretoria. Greetings in the Western Cape. Greetings in Didier, Gauteng. Greetings in Dobsonville, Johannesburg. Greetings in Gaborone, Botswana. Greetings in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Greetings in London, UK. Greetings in Manitoba, Canada. Greetings in Uganda. Greetings in Cyprus. Greetings in Nairobi, Kenya. Greetings in Malawi. Greetings in Zimbabwe. Greetings in North Macedonia. Greetings in Ireland. If I did not mention your country, your city, your state, please kindly let us know in the comment section where you are connecting from, beloveds. Your interactions mean so much to us. Please kindly let us know in the comment section where you are connecting from. Now, the prophetic word that the Holy Spirit has laid in my spirit for me to release today is God will do it for you unexpectedly. God will do it for you unexpectedly. You're about to testify. Ah, Babo City. I feel it in my spirit that there's a wave. There's a new move of God that is about to catch his people unaware. I know you've been praying. I know you're expecting. But the way in which God is about to do things is going to be so unexpected that is about to blow your mind. It's about to blow your mind. 1 Corinthians 2 verse 9, it says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can conceive the things that God has prepared for his people, for those who are called according to his purpose. There are things that God has prepared for you. There are things that God has prepared for you that he is about to do for you right now. And he's going to act unexpectedly. And the reason why the Bible says no eye has seen is because what God is about to do for you is something that people have never seen before. Ah, Bala Babu City. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. If I can give you a biblical example, what God did for Esther had never been done before, because God made her queen in a foreign land which she wasn't even of their tribe. She was a Christian. She was a Hebrew. She was not even of their tribe, but God made her queen. God literally like snuck her in the kingdom through Mordecai. So what God is about to do for you is so divine. The word divine means of God, that it's something that people have never seen before. I mean, what have you seen before? Like the story of Joseph, where literally from inmate to prime minister. Where have you ever seen that before? It's something that does not happen every day. What God is about to do for you is such a rare miracle. It's so custom made that eyes have not seen it, ears have not heard it, neither has it entered the mind of man, meaning it has never been conceived before, because it is not just an idea, it is a miracle custom made for you. There are some things that are getting ready to work in your favor unexpectedly. There are things that are getting ready to work in your favor unexpectedly. Psalm 138, verse 8, it says, "For the Lord perfects that which concerns me." Ah, Maraboshete, I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying He is intervening in that matter that is concerning you, and the verdict will be ruled in your favor. I hear the Spirit of God saying, justice granted. For some of you, it's actually a court case, and God is saying, justice granted. For some of you, it is a dispute in the workplace. Malabosete, justice granted. For some of you, you've been praying to God for a matter. It's a personal matter, and you were saying, Lord, I need justice in this area. I need justice to be granted in this area. God is saying, justice granted. Ah, God is about to do it for you. He's about to move in an unexpected way in your life right now. La Babo City, unexpected divine connections, unexpected business connections, unexpected work connections. You're about to get that job supernaturally. Supernatural. Some of you, you haven't even applied. You don't even know that they've advertised the post. You are supernaturally going to get appointed, because God has seen your heart. God has seen your toiling, and He is about to bless you with that job supernaturally. Unexpected connections, kingdom marriage connections, out of nowhere, God Himself is going to orchestrate a meeting with you and your kingdom spouse. So get ready, because God is moving in unexpected ways. Ooh, la barabo city. The house that you've been praying for, God is going to slash the price in half just so that you can qualify for that house. Ah, what God is about to do for you is so unexpected. You're not even expecting it, even as you hear this word, because when it happens, you will remember, I pray that when it happens, that God will bring into remembrance this prophetic word, because this prophetic word, it is a rhema word. Things are about to happen right now. So remember that God told you to expect the unexpected. And when it happens, remember to praise God. Remember to thank God. I pray that you will remember this prophetic video as it happens, so that you can come back and give God the glory, because God is about to move back, is about to move in ways you've never seen before. He's about to astound you. You are like, oh God, my life has this particular pattern where things move and things don't go right, and then there's a dip. Listen, God is about to shock you. Expect the unexpected. That building you've been praying for your business, for your organization, your ministry, God is about to bring forth divine funding for it. That business, divine funding for it, divine sponsorship for it. People are going to fund your vision. That ministry, God is going to bring kingdom finances that are going to believe in that vision. God is bringing forth major changes in your life. That car is coming unexpectedly. God is about to move in mysterious and unexpected ways to perform his wonders in your life. I am going to say that again. God is about to move in mysterious and unexpected ways to perform his wonders in your life. So get ready, get excited. God is moving. God is moving, beloveds. And I cannot wait for your testimonies. Lord, as you have said it, so shall it be. Thank you even for the testimonies that are coming from this word. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you so much, beloveds. Thank you for those of you who are sending in your prayer requests, your praise reports, your testimonies. Thank you for those of you who are sowing seeds. Thank you, beloveds. You are enabling us to continue to take the gospel of Jesus Christ to the nations. If the Holy Spirit has touched your heart and you are led to support this ministry and you are led to sow into this particular word, all our information is in the description box. I love you all so much, beloveds. God richly bless you. Shalom.